Good morning. So, Snippet.Pixie. Next. Oops. Didn't mean to do that. I meant to go into Go-land. Okay. So, the way I left it last time, excuse me, was I was struggling with getting the DBus server for this new version to return a new snippet structure back to the CLI. There's my little to-do. Work out how to return a struct via DBus. Well, I had a quick look and I don't think it's actually the returning of a struct as such that's the problem. I think the problem is that I am trying to pass a time field back, which I don't think is supported. I need to instead use something like an int64 timestamp, which is a bit annoying because that's how I was doing it beforehand. When I was doing Goal Monitor, I used a timestamp, and for whatever reason this time I decided to just use time instead, and I shouldn't have. I should have done in 64 because it's more transportable. So that's what I've got to do, I think. I'll show you what the actual problem is. Let's see. Yeah, so if I just make sure I've got this built. Go build. So, Snippet.Pixied. Alright, so that's the DBus server. And then in here, I've got a CLI. If I do that, add SP back. Actually, I probably need to quote it properly. And Snippet.Pixied. Oh, this might not work because I might have already. No, it did. That's fine. It's going to go bang. And it's saying empty struct. When we've done debugging, we know it's not an empty struct. And in fact, it would have actually done the job. If I look at the database, here's the snippets table. It's just created that. I don't have a create date on there, actually. Maybe one day do that. Anyway, let's delete that from the database. And let's see if we can get this fixed. So, this means I need to update the package definition for Snippet, first and foremost. Let's make sure that the tests are running, though. That's slow. What's going on there? Maybe because I've just recently rebooted and I've got a whole bunch of things up and running. Okay, back there. All right, check this runs. Yeah, and then back in the package, which is where I'm going to be working just now. God, that's slow. Maybe I should have done all my updates a little bit earlier. That's interesting. I wonder if it's a tmux thing, because it's definitely, I mean, it's telling me it's done it in no time at all, so could be a compiler thing. Anyway, right, let's get going. So I'm going to change this to an int 64. So I'm now going to start using a timestamp. So let's find out how I'm using this, which is going to be in a few places. Let's start with snippet itself. Got that's where we're defining. Hold on a sec. Right. Add snippet. Okay, so I'm passing in a time. And the UTC format. And I'm storing it. As a timestamp. So that's okay. The problem here is we need to then return it as an N64. Should do. And then where else have we used it? Here. So this is in get snippet. So it's doing all the right things there. The timestamp is converted into time. And then we just need to switch it back to Unix. What's the other options there, actually? Unix Mili, Unix Micro, Unix Nano. No, I don't want good with Unix. Don't need Nano. Okay. So let's start from the top here again now. So we're going to get a response back. The daemon. And it's in 64, which is good because it's calling add snippet and getting a straight snippet back, which is fine. and then here in the test. Yeah. It seems a bit weird, doesn't it? Do Unix and then return Unix. Oh. That's them done. And then here, we've got another one. That's just comparing the expected to the expected, so that's fine too. Done those two. This looks fine. Oh no, okay, right, so this is where things might need to change. Hold on, so that's getting back in that case. Yeah, so we're returning. Gonna have to do something similar to that. Don't even know what that's for. Check that in a minute. What's that reminder for? Yeah, that was a reminder to myself that I need to use an N64. So here we go. So we've got a snippet that we're trying to create, but we can't just use straight in there. I suspect that'll be wrong. Probably need to do this. We scan into a time field. Then assign snippet last used to be last used Unix version. Then append the new snippet. That should work. I believe. We'll have to do the same here. Oops. And get snippets, yeah. Keep scanning into there, get the Unix version store. That's fine. And what else we got? Last one here. Update snippet. So pass in a snippet, which will have an int64. So in that case, we need to switch it out. Let's take no, we can do that straight away. We can do that, that's not a problem. So we've gone in 64 and we need to convert it the other way around now. Let me think. Yeah, no, it's probably easiest that we get there. Do it on a variable. That would be a little bit safer. Yeah, so last used equals snippet last used, and then what do we do here? I can't remember now. Actually, it should be is time Unix snippet last used. I know it's always used UTC as well. So that's not needed anymore. I could, I guess, do it straight in there, but it's a little bit neater to the variable so we know what we're doing. Okay, yeah, so convert timestamp into, we know it's Unix time, convert it to UTC time zone and go use it. Okay. So that's good. And then we've got a few tests to look at. Add snippet, blah, blah, blah. Well, I guess all these should just work. It should always be converted before you get it back. So that should be okay. Okay, that's going to be different. Because we're using a variable there, so we're expecting Unix there. Same there. Updated should be the same as input there. Am I right there? Last used. Okay. And then the last bit. Not doing anything with the last used. Okay. Let's run those tests again, see what happens. So in the package, passes. In the daemon, passes. Let's go back to CLI. Passes. Okay. Right, so close that off. That off. Daemon main can go. We've done the work we need in there. So in here. In theory, we're getting a snippet within 64. It's the CLI we now need to double check. So we should store back a new snippet, which should have in 64, and return that. And that is being called by the add snippet. And we're just logging out at the moment. So that should just print out in 64 at the moment. Okay. Let's see what happens. Let's build this. And run it. And then try and add a snippet. What? Cannot store a value of UID date into UID. So what was that? Did it actually do it? It did. So again, we're having problems getting it back. But it's on the client side this time. So here we've got the service. Passing an abbreviation and body and trying to get a snippet back. And somehow that's gone wrong. That's an interesting method to use. Oh, okay. Oh, that's interesting. Again, that's another type problem on struct. You're going to have simpler data going back and forwards. Just like you would on like a JavaScript fetch. You don't want to be sending, if you're using like TypeScript and stuff, you don't want to have types being transferred really. So, okay. Interesting that the server doesn't complain about that though. Let's decompose it, okay. So that's a bit. So I wonder if I should have a special struct simply for passing back and forward with different types in it, and just little wrapper function that allows you to convert it back and forwards. So what I'm thinking is, because I want to really use UUIDs and preferably time values, I could have special, like sort of service caller functions that wrap a snippet. For getting, for storing it and translating it. Then again, the whole point of the little DBus sub package as such of the CLI is to do the right thing. Yeah, I think I've done that around the wrong way. I think in the... I should stick to having snippets using a UUID and a time field. And then in the CLI, I switch the UUID to a string and the time field to a timestamp, int64. And then the DBus that's all it needs to deal with. But then I need a different type to make sure it's easy to reflect and so on. Decisions, because it If I switch everything to a string for the UID instructs, it does mean guess. For the package, would kind of have an easier time with it. It's doing the auto switch into string, no problem there. If I define the service caller, so it uses a different type of snippet. No, that's not what I want. Okay. I think I'm going to put it back to how it was. And I think, yeah. And then just in the DBus stuff, I'll do the translation. Yeah, I think so. So in a DBus. Yeah. Let's do this. Still expect a normal snippet to come in, but we now have we don't need to call it dbus because we can, it's on a package. So we have a service caller snippet and a snippet snippet. Yeah, okay. And then so the daemon. We're going getting a normal snippet. No, I don't. No, we return. Sorry. Return a service caller snippet. So that should be complaining now I'm not doing the right thing. Oh, I've got to do all the ad stuff, haven't I? Right. Cat.mod. So, replace, oops, go, mod, edit, place, this, at, e, 0.0. Unpublished is equal to. Let's type that right. Unpublished v0.0.0. Unpublished. Yep. It's equal to. That package service caller and then we do So I look at it again. It now knows about Service Corner and it knows it's replaced with the local version. Okay. So that should resolve. Didn't even have to refresh. Cool. Okay, so it now knows what Service Caller snippet looks like, which is all using simpler data structures. So we need, in this case, right, the response we know is going to actually be a snippet from the database stuff. This is going to be instead a service caller snippet. And this is to a string. And this is to Unix. I'll take that to-do out. Right, so that's good for that. He says, optimistically. And then on the DBus for CLI, again, we are returning a snippet here, but we need to compose that. From a response, which is going to be an empty service caller snippet. Like that. So we get back a response, hopefully okay, and then well, we don't even need a new snippet here, do we? We can do a return. New. Oops. Snippet with the values ID response dot ID. Now I've got to construct a UUID from that. How do I do that? Let's go look at the package stuff. It's probably on Marshall, isn't it? Let's go look at the dock. That's a from string. Perfect. Okay. Let's try that. Where are we? Here. So you ID. Dot from string response dot ID theory, that's okay. Why is that complaining? Oh. Because it could return an error. That's a good point. Did I do that in the DBus then? No, in the package. No, because it's got the error catch, it already does that, I guess. Interesting. Okay. So, yeah. Put that in there. And we're going to do abbreviation comes from the response dot abbreviation body, same again, comes from response body, and then last used comes from the response dot last used, in this form, in theory. So, the response back from calling the DBus server is a special kind of snippet using plain fields. We get the UUID from the ID string. We get abbreviation and body OK. We also have to get from a int64, yeah, seconds, with no nanoseconds, into a Unix time field for the actual snippet that we're returning. It's okay. So that's that. So CLI DBus is all fixed up. Does return the right thing. Here we're printing it. Now we've got to fix up. That's okay, that's just doing that. We need to fix up the package tests. I think we need to go back on that because we mucked it up just before. Yeah, we can just revert that now. Dunk. So they should be working the same as they did before. And what else do we muck about with? Main test we've just looked at. DBus test. Yeah, so on the CLI, yeah, we're expecting a timestamp back. So that should be okay there. should be reverted now. Service caller, we've just updated. And probably, I don't know if we can do any. Can't really do any tests for that. Okay. Right. I got rid of the table data, didn't I? Yeah. I think we can give it a go. So build this. So clear. Let's run. Okay, so far so good. And then here. I should probably run the tests. But anyway. Let's give it a quick run first. String to UUID. Okay, so there's something wrong there. Let's run the tests. Okay. Better just run the tests here as well. Oh, okay. DBus test 77. Expected last used date. Okay. DBus test on the daemon. Oh, that's right. Okay, yeah, because the service. Returns a service caller snippet. Okay. Right. That's that bit tested, but we really kind of knew that was working anyway. Right, so I'm getting back what we expect. And then on the CLI, can't convert string to UID. All right, well, why? Let's see what's going on. I'll just do a quick look. Speed, let's get rid of that snippet that was probably just created. Yep. I mean, that looks okay. And we need to go build and run the test. Interesting. Oh, it's the store, of course. Oh, okay. Hold on a minute. Why is it even trying to? It's complaining about. Can I convert string to UID? But that's not what's being returned. Returning a snippet with a string. Doing it all the way around. Okay, UID. It's doing the right thing there. Returning a normal UID. That's very confusing. Definitely a string. Passing in abbreviation and body expecting the snippet back. I'm confused. Everything's correct, so why is that? Enter the provided pointers. Returns an error if the signature of the body and return values don't match, or if the error status is not nil. It's just nuts. Okay, well, I'm confused now, so. And I'm out of time. Let's think. I can't see why it's complaining about that particular message. I wonder if it's just getting a bit confused somehow. It's on the server side. It can't be. It's a string. Oh, hold on a minute. I wonder. One last little test here. And then I've got to go. Interesting there that I could use a pointer. I'm wondering. I'm wondering if our snippets doing got a problem there. It's creating one from scratch. Anyway, maybe let's clean out the database again. This is a debug. And then CLI. Oops. So we're in here. Fine. Oh, okay. So it's the inset. I thought I'd deleted it. Oh, it's a debug thing. Okay. I'm in the debug database now, aren't I? Okay. So dink into there over that. Okay, commits. Now got an ID. It looks okay. Body and everything else looks okay. So the snippet. It's okay. So we have a response. No error. New snippet string, last use is a zero. So that's everything's okay there. And that's it. So it's not on the DBus server side. Must be the unmarshal end somehow. Okay. Well, here's a quick test then. If I do this instead. So I'm just throwing it away, but so I'm just going to create a new UID. Right, run the server. Did I save that? I did. Compile and run. That's fine. Where on earth is that happening? It's so weird. There's nothing. I mean, this is way too late. It's definitely happening here. Okay, another thing to look at. When I get a chance. To do. Is this store causing string to UID error? Because I have no idea. I don't know how that's even working, since there is no UUID in that snippet. The only thing I can think it is that since I originally had the service running with UUID, maybe that's logged somewhere in the system. Like a service file has been created. That's possible, I guess. But if so, that means UID was okay to be transported. Maybe it can be decomposed. Okay, well, I'll have to put that out some other time. Can't keep on poking at that. That's when I've got other stuff to do. Yeah, okay. Well, until next time, thanks for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.